Well, after all the brouhaha, the government survived. A safe majority of 16, some subtle amendments to the Lord's amendments about a meaningful vote, some blurring at the edges of the line. The rebels go back in the box and Theresa May carries on. Now, if politics was only about survival, then Theresa May would be conducting a masterclass every week. She'd be the greatest prime minister in history. But politics is about more than just survival. I think the government's in real trouble. One indication of that this week was the extraordinary decision to relaunch the Boris Johnson double-decker bus. The £350 million lie of the referendum campaign is reincarnated. It's going to come to pass in the National Health Service. The problem is, everybody knows it was a lie. It was a bluff. Everybody knows that Brexit's going to cost money, not gain money. Therefore, to claim welcome funds additional for the health service as a result of Brexit is clearly a deception. And any politician who tries to articulate that argument, particularly out with a campaign, is demeaning themselves, as Theresa May demeaned herself last weekend. To do it to try and bolster support among Brexiteers, because they're worried about the concession that are being made to Remainers, is an illustration of prime ministerial weakness. I had a theory, the first time I'd heard it this week, that Theresa May was actually deliberately dividing the Conservative Party and her cabinet and Parliament because her own vision of a very soft Brexit could come through the middle and win the day. And therefore, successively, she has Brexiteers, Remainers at loggerheads as she skillfully manipulates the political scene to obtain what she wants of a soft Brexit. It's an ingenious theory. It's also total rubbish. I don't think the Prime Minister has a clue what she's trying to achieve from the Brexit process. I think the Prime Minister's grand strategy is merely survival. I think it's day-to-day and hand-to-mouth. And even if she did come up with a strategy, then she probably wouldn't have a parliamentary majority to sustain it. She's meeting the impossible conundrum, not just the insoluble Irish border question, but the whole idea of how you unite a party fundamentally divided and riven between hard Brexiteers and convinced Remainers. It cannot be done. Even someone of the subtle political skills of Harold Wilson couldn't manage it, and Theresa May certainly won't. The one thing she is good at is hanging around, is surviving, is hanging on. But at the end of the day, there comes a moment where that is not enough to satisfy any politician, even Theresa May. Your political legacy cannot just be that you were there. It's not like Theresa was here and then left. That is no political legacy. Being incapable of coming up with a Brexit strategy, being capable of making decisions, constantly dodging the bullets as they come towards you, may be a recipe for political survival, but it is certainly not a political legacy.